Good morning, my dear students. Hope you all are doing great and also you have celebrated Eid in a very prosperous way. So, my dear students, till now we have completed three sections from module 2, right? So, today this is the last class of our module 2 and today we will be doing the other two sections, that is the writing part. So, today we will be learning number 1, the note writing. Okay, and the second one will be the creative writing. Correct? So before that, we will do a quick recap of what we have done in our last class. My dear students, in our last class, we discussed about contraction. Right? So let's do a quick recap of what is a contraction. Contraction is the shortened form of two words. It is formed when two words are combined into one using an apostrophe. Let's see a sentence. We are sure it will rain today. If we write the contracted form of the words we and are, it will be fair. Yes? So the above sentence using contraction will be, we're sure it will rain. Got it? Hope you have understood what is contraction, right? So my dear students, now let's see the difference between possessives and contractions. So my dear students, here I have made two columns. One is of possessive and the other is of contraction. So let's see first possessive. A possessive noun tells who or what owns or has something. Contractions are words made by combining two words or leaving out one or more letters. Got it? Possessives. To show singular possession of nouns, we add s with apostrophe. In contraction, an apostrophe takes the place of removed letter. Example for possessive, the student's paintbrush is on the floor. Example for contraction is, the books haven't been covered yet. Got it, everyone? So, my dear students, today we are going to learn note writing. Before I start, can you just tell me whether you have written any short message to your friends or family? I hope you have, right? Many a times we write many short messages to our friends or our family members. So, my dear students, now please come to page number 18. Before writing a note, we should know what are notes. Notes are used to share short messages in one or two sentences. And also, it can be a short record of something that is written down to help us remember the memory letter. My dear students, always remember there is a format of writing any text. Yes, like letters, notes or stories. Got it? Okay. The points or parts that you have to follow while writing a note are salutation or greeting. So the number one part is salutation or greeting. Salutation or greetings are used to greet or address the person whom you are writing the note. How you can address the person depends on how close you are to them. But without a salutation, a note is incomplete, right? So the second part is the body. Body is that part of the note where we write only the main idea that we want to convey. As I told that notes are written only in one or two sentences, right? So what you have to do? Your body, it has to be very precise. Yes, you have to write down only the main points in there. Now, come to the last part of the format, that is the signature. Signature includes the name of the note writer who is writing the note. This is the last line of the entire note. How you sign off also depends on how close you are to that person. Now, let's understand the format with an example. Here is a note from Mrs. Asha Tuli to Parth. Here the salutation greeting is mentioned by writing dear. Let's see what is in the body of the note. You did well in the test. Keep up the good work. Have you seen it? Okay, we have completed the body of the note. Here comes the signature part now. As I mentioned earlier, signature is the last line of the note. So here we end it by writing best wishes along with the name of the writer. Yes, Mrs. Asha Tuli. So my dear students, hope you understood. So how many parts are there? There are three parts, right? The number one is the salutation or greetings. Number two is the body. And the last part is the signature part, right? Okay, so now we will be doing the textual exercise. So come to exercise number four. Your cousin Nilima is participating in an inter-school boxing championship. Fill in the gaps to complete this note to wish her love. So already the format is given in a very nice manner, right? So what we have to do, we have to just fill the gaps. Dear Nilima, salutation, right? It is great to know that you are participating in the inter-school boxing championship. I'm sure you will do very well. All the best. With love, Sarita. So Sarita is writing the note. Yes, and to whom? To Nilima. So the body is written very nicely in only one and two sentences, like it is great to know that you are participating in the inter-school boxing championship. I'm sure you will do very well. All the best. So you have seen it's written in a very precise way. Yes? Okay. So my dear students, here we come to the last section of module 2, creative writing. Creative writing is also a powerful activity that encourages us to open our minds to be more comfortable in expressing our own thoughts and views. It helps us to write down anything, okay, any writing in a very open manner using your own creativity, whatever you want to add there. Sometimes suppose a teacher asks you to write down about yourself. Yes, what you do? You just explore with new words in what way you can express yourself, right? So creative writing helps us to know or write any text in a very creative manner. Yes, so my dear students, today's homework for you all is exercise 5. In here, you have to write down a personal experience of your. Okay, so in your exercise 5, we have write about an incident you have or your family helped your neighbors or when your neighbors helped you. Okay, or your family. So what you have to do here, you have to write an experience, okay, your personal experience where you have helped your neighbors or your neighbors have helped you. Okay, so my dear students, it's time to wrap up now. So let's do a quick summarization of what we have learned today. We have learned about note writing, the format of note writing, and creative writing. Right? So my dear students, if there is any confusion regarding the topics done, you can just call me or text me about it. Right? We can revisit the topics in our next class. Okay? So thank you.